What's going on, Samurais? Welcome to today's video. Today, I want to talk about how to bring an animated lower third with a transparent background into OBS. Now, this is a great way to up your production value of your live streams. Now, this video is going to assume that you already have built your animated lower third and you've exported it and it's ready to come into OBS. Now, if you haven't done that or you need help doing that, I have two other videos that you may want to go check out. I will put a link to both of them in the description below. The first one is how to build an animated lower third with a transparent background inside of Final Cut Pro X using a Photoshop file, and the other one shows you how to export the lower third out of Final Cut Pro X with an alpha channel or transparent background. So it's time to bring in our animated lower third with transparent background. But the first thing we need to do is make sure that we're on the right scene. So I'm going to come down to where it says scenes and click on scene one. Scene one is this full frame shot of me, and of course I want my animated lower third to come up right here. Once we have chosen the correct scene, we're going to add a new source. So we're going to come over to the little source box, come down to the plus icon, click on plus, click on media source. That will bring up this little pop-up here, and you can name it. I'm just going to leave it media source. Then click OK, and we will get another pop-up box. This is where we're going to point to our animated lower third. So I'm going to go to where it says locate file, click on browse. I have mine located on the desktop, my file. I'm going to click on my file, click open. Now we have pointed OBS at our animated lower third file. Now there are some settings here. I typically leave all of the settings on default. Once you're done, click OK. So the first way we can pull up our animated lower third is we can go down to where it says source and go to media source, which is our animated lower third file. And we can click on this little eye right here next to it. So when the eye has the slash through it, that means the element is deactivated. The second I click it, you will see our animated lower third pops up. So the other way you can access your animated lower third is you can have it pop up when you switch between scenes. Now the way you set this up is you come down to where it says scene, you click on scene, then we go over to sources, and we make sure that our animated lower third is activated. So our animated lower third is called media source. So we make sure that that little eyeball doesn't have the slash through it. Now when we switch between scenes, so right now we're on scene three, which is the computer screen. So when I switch to scene one, which is me full frame, you will see our animated lower third pops up 1, 2, 3. Now there is one very important thing you need to know. If you don't want this to pop up every time you switch back to scene one or scene two or wherever your animated lower third is located, you need to go back down to the sources where the little eyeball is and make sure after the animated lower third is done playing, you click on the little eyeball again, disabling it, turning off the element. That way when you switch back and forth, it won't pop up. All right, Samurais, that's going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it and you want to see more content just like this, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, if you're brand new around here and you're checking out the channel for the first time, make sure you go click that subscribe button. We would love to have you as part of the familia. Also, if you have any questions about anything I talked about in today's video, make sure to ask them in the comment section below. And until next time, remember to dream big, think bigger, and always be you. I love you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye.